Hi, my name is Clarion, and a few months ago, I got diagnosed with Friedreich's ataxia, or FA, like my brother Jake. I'm in the fourth grade, and I live with my awesome family, my mom, my dad, my two brothers, and my two sisters.
And that's me.
You might already know about FA. Maybe because you've researched it, but probably because you've watched my brother Jake's video. But if you haven't, here's the link. When I got diagnosed with FA, I knew it was a genetic disease, but I still wondered how I got it.
Well, I told you in my video that you couldn't get it from me. I'm not contagious.
True. So my mom, dad, and I researched and learned more. Since I've been diagnosed with FA, I've learned a few things about it. I've learned that it's a mitochondrial disease that affects my balance and coordination, and also my energy and endurance. I've also learned that FA affects everyone differently. This is all because of a GAA trinucleotide repetition error on the 9th chromosome.
Katie, do you know what a chromosome is?
Ellie, I don't even know what a trinucleotide is.
So I guess I'll have to explain this. Let's start by talking about chromosomes. Each person has 23 pairs of chromosomes. You get half from your mom and half from your dad. Copies of these chromosomes can be found in the nucleus of every cell in your body. If you look closely at these chromosomes, you can see that they're made up of tightly wound strands of proteins called DNA. DNA is the instruction manual to tell your body how to make you pretty much you. It tells you whether you should have red hair or blonde hair, or if you're bald, or if you're stocky or slender, if you're short, or if you're tall. Sometimes the DNA is written improperly, and that's what happens with FA. This disease is caused by a GAA trinucleotide repetition error in the 9th chromosome. This pretty much means that the instructions are going just fine until they hit the 9th chromosome, and it just starts repeating GAA, 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 and the cells get confused and can't function properly. Remember how I told you that chromosomes come in pairs? Well, if you have the GAA repetition error in only one of your 9th chromosomes, then you're a silent carrier of FA.
Shh! Is this a silent carrier?
No. Even though your DNA has the GAA repetition error in the one chromosome, you will never have any signs or symptoms of FA because the other chromosome is dominant, and that's the one the cells listens to. If both of the 9th chromosomes have the GAA repetition error, that means you have FA. We know that chromosomes are passed from parents to their kids. So after Jake was diagnosed, my mom and my dad asked my family members going back generations if anyone had ever heard of FA. No one had. So I learned how genetics are passed from generation to generation with a really cool thing called a Punnett square. Because none of my ancestors have had FA, we can assume that all of the generations before my parents had one silent FA carrier who married and had kids with a person who had two completely normal 9th chromosomes. When this happens, their kids have two possibilities. They could either get this dominant chromosome from one parent and this dominant chromosome from the other parent and be a non-carrier, or they could get a recessive chromosome from one parent and a dominant chromosome from the other and be a silent carrier. and they have an equal chance of either possibility. Because my brother and I both have FA, we know that by definition, my mom and dad must be silent carriers. When a silent carrier marries a silent carrier, there are now three possibilities. You could get the dominant chromosome from one parent and the dominant chromosome from the other parent and be a non-carrier. Or you could get the recessive chromosome from one parent and the dominant chromosome from the other parent and be a silent carrier, or you could get the recessive chromosome from one parent and the recessive chromosome from the other and have FA. Unfortunately, that's what happened to me and Jake. My younger brother and my sisters got tested at the same time I did. Luckily, none of them have FA. No one can control what chromosomes they get. It's all a matter of chance. So those are the three possibilities. You're either a silent carrier, a non-carrier, or like me and Jake, you have FA. As I've said before, Friedreich's ataxia is really rare. Only 1 in 50,000 people have it. But do you want to hear a statistic that will blow your mind? 1 in 100 people are silent carriers of the FA gene. That's 1% of everyone, and most likely they have no idea. To put this statistic into perspective, on any football Saturday in Ann Arbor, there are more than 100,000 people who come to cheer for the Michigan team. So statistically speaking, there are more than 1,000 silent carriers at the stadium watching the game. For even more amazing perspective, listen to this. There are 7 billion humans on Earth. That means whether they know it or not, there are 70 million silent carriers of the FA gene in the world. No matter who they are, no matter where they live, every single person who's a silent carrier or has FA can trace their ancestry back to one single person who lived in Europe 10,000 years ago. Starting with that person, the mutated FA gene got passed from generation to generation, all the way down to my parents. My mom and dad met at the University of Michigan. They didn't know then, but we know now. They were 2 of those 1,000 silent carriers watching the game. I don't like having FA. FA makes me feel sad because I know I'm going to be in a wheelchair in the future. FA also makes me feel nervous because I don't know what the future holds. I don't know how fast my symptoms are going to come and how bad they'll be. The thing I'm most worried about with FA is that in the future, when I'm different from everyone else, that my friends will treat me differently. And I just wanted to let you know that I'm still the same person that I was before you watched this video. What can I do about it? I've learned that the best thing I can do is to stay healthy by eating well and exercising. I like to swim, play tennis, play basketball. I've gone rock climbing. I like to go on hikes with my family, and I've even gone skiing. And when my dad has his camera posed for picture after 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 picture, it's exhausting. But worth it. As you know, FA has no treatment and no cure right now. But doctors are working on it, So that's pretty cool. Having FA really stinks, but I'm going to participate in research to help the doctors find a cure. Clinical trials are when the doctors test a medication to see if it could help the disease. Biomarker studies are research that helps the doctors know more about FA and to see how it affects the people who have it. The reason why participating in clinical trials and biomarker studies is so important is because it gives doctors and scientists who are working on a cure for FA important information. And it also gives me a lot of optimism that they're doing good work. So you might be wondering what you can do about FA. Well, you can send me money, but it would be much better if you sent money directly to FARA. All those clinical trials are exciting, but they will only work if the scientists have support and money for that research. If you're wondering how to make a donation to FARA, their website is right here. And I'm very appreciative. Having FA makes me sad and it makes me nervous. But I'm really optimistic about the future. Thank you for watching this video, and I know that together we will cure FA.
Mm-hmm.